Yo, what's going on? It's me, Boss Cat Astronaut, with another update. So today we're going to talk about two projects. First project we're going to talk about is none other than the suspense is killing you, isn't it? None other than Mutant Hounds Collars. Mutant Hounds Collars. This has been described as a layer two BAYC project. So affiliated, but not, right? And we're also going to talk about the Ape Society, right? So let's go ahead and get into it. If you like this content, I want you to like and subscribe. But let's talk about this project, right? So I actually want to start out with the Ape Society. Now, the Ape Society's current floor is 10.8K ADA, right? This is a project that came out a while ago. The first project that actually had first and last names associated with the NFT. A very amazing and structured ecosystem of families and class levels. But what was more intriguing is what these guys did afterwards. They created utility. They created a token economy. And I'd argue and say they are the best. They are the top project for decentralized finance, the top CNFT project on Cardano. They've done an amazing job. And that's what you see with the floor price here of 10.8K Cardano for every single Ape Society NFT. Now, wanted to kind of touch on a few things here. So, recently they have a craftsman, so it's one of their tier systems. The craftsmen are able to build essentially furniture and other things that go into what's called an ape cabin, Ape Society cabin. They're able to earn society token or keep these for themselves, but it speaks to the utility of these craftsmen that are part of the ecosystem of the Ape Society. These guys have done an incredible job. Shout out to Congo and the crew. Recently, I want to give Congo a shout out because his level of engagement on Twitter and the storytelling that he's doing, he's been taking it to the next level lately. So I really want to give him a shout out. I heard him in a couple of Twitter spaces as well, and I'm really excited with where things are going, right? So here's a prime example. If you owned an Ape Society Craftsman NFT, you could begin to build out some of these different things. So the piece that this guy or gal chose, was a bar, which takes 18 days to build. And then you can sell that for society token, or you can utilize it in your ape cabin, right? So I just want to put that out there. In terms of the Ape Society, they're getting a lot of interesting offers on some of their high level NFTs. So if it's a higher tier family or class, or if it's a king within one of the families, you're starting to see these offers of 60K ADA. I believe a king the other day sold for 260K ADA or 250K ADA. So they're doing incredible. Kudos to the team. And what's scary is these guys are constantly building and identifying new opportunities to make the ecosystem better. One of the key components to their success, in my opinion, is that they listen. They created a real DAO that actually focused on hearing what the people wanted, and they helped the people build it. And they've done an incredible job. So I've been wanting to do a video giving them a shout out for a while. I want to do something more in depth and kind of really run through this for you. But I wanted to give Ape Society a shout out for the amazing storytelling, the amazing token economy that they've created on Cardano and really brought DeFi to the forefront and added utility to CNFTs in a way that we had not seen before. A close second would be Clay Nation, but that's for another video. But shout out to the team. Kudos to you guys. Keep up the good work. Now, we're going to get into another project called Mutant Hounds Collars. Okay? Now, this project is crazy, right? Mutant Hounds is essentially a project that is incorporating a lot like of this. Things, storytelling.
Think I wouldn't return.
And hold on, let me mute that. Lots of interesting storytelling. As you can see here, there's supposed to be a launch of, I believe, Mecha Apes, Mechanical Apes, and we're supposed to have mechanical dogs or mutant dogs. Look at these mecha apes. To me, these look like mechanical apes, but they're part of the storytelling that's associated with this Mutant Hounds. As you can see, the Mutant Hounds there as well. Really, really interesting. This video talks about choosing a side, right? And this is all ran by Mutant DAO, right? The Mutant Cartel, which is a mutant DAO. So I want to start off there. Their recent post on Twitter talks about chapter one of the Hound saga starts soon. Then the Hounds mint. Keep your eyes peeled. How? Right? So here's what's interesting, guys. Let's go ahead and go to OpenSea really quick. Let's check it out. Right? So we're going to go to OpenSea, and we're going to go to Mutant Hounds Collars. All right. And want to kind of break this down and give you an idea of where we're at in this process with this particular project. What's really, really interesting here is this project it's a burn to rebuild, right? So these NFTs have not been revealed yet. We're not even there yet. So I'm really, really excited to kind of show you guys where we're at, if we can get this thing to pull up. I don't know why it's loading. Let's go ahead and take a look here. Current floor price is 1.15 ETH. If you had a Mutant Cartel Oath NFT, then you were able to mint this for 0.15 ETH. One ETH profit is incredible. And like I said before, they're burned to reveal. Burned to mint or whatever. So right now you have these collars, and then you have, so there's 10,000 NFTs. You have 10,000 collars that you're going to utilize to reveal your hound if you choose to, if you burn that NFT. If you don't, you just hold on to it, right? But within that 10,000, there were 25 megas, mega collars. The mega collars have sold anywhere from 31 ETH. I saw one for 42.5, another for over 60 ETH. So you already have some gamification and strategy going on with these NFTs already, and we're already above one ETH. As Lior.eth, he owns quite a few of the megas, including the gold Mega Mutant from the Mutant Ape Yacht Club. They've really been putting in some work in developing an amazing storyline and lore that we can all appreciate. Unfortunately, I don't know why that didn't load, guys, but what we're going to do is this. Now, he says the saga is going to begin soon, okay? Is there any other pertinent information here? Somebody says, recently described as a Bored Ape Yacht Club Layer 2. Is this worth buying, right? So let's let's check out the thread just really quick, right? Now, the team is solid. The team is actually really incredible. They have some amazing Mutant Cartel storytelling. You can kind of check this thread out. But I really thought this illustrated a lot of things as well. So you have the oath that you can purchase. If you had that, you're able to mint very early, and it kind of gives you a breakdown. But these are the Mutant Hounds reveal that we're really looking forward to. So right now, actually, hold on one sec. Actually, we're good. Right now, we went from the story in hands layer to the collar, mint, and burn. So we're in the stage of the collar, mint, and burn. And you're going to get your Mutant Hounds reveal very, very soon. We don't know when that's going to be, but it's going to be soon. Keep your eyes open on this project. But there's more utility associated with the project if you go look up the Mutant Cartel. You can go to their Twitter page, and there's more information here as well. This has taken the value, in my opinion, of mutant apes to the next level with what they're bringing to the table. And I want to finish up with this really quick. These are Mutant Hounds, and they're already building in the other side. What is scary is, look how big these hounds are. Look, you're going to be able to utilize these in the other side. And let's go to my Twitter page really quick. This is where it gets really scary. Is I put a video up a couple of days ago, right here. Yeah. Let's keep that on me. Alright. Look, that's what this is going to look like in the other side. Look at the mutant ape and look how big the hounds are. It's incredible. So get ready for some real utility. They're talking about choosing different sides. The storytelling is top notch. Very, very interesting project. Gamification on whether or not you want to burn to reveal your mutant hound or not. And there's lots of upside ahead. So I encourage you guys to do some more research. I'm going to do a more in-depth video later, but this is enough for now. Shout out to the Ape Society. Also, shout out to the Mutant Cartel. I own my oath. I'm part of the crew. Shout out to Mutant Hounds, Leor.eth, and the team. Very, very impressed and very interested in what we're going to see next. As I always say, guys, start every day with a grateful heart. Feel free to like and subscribe, and I'll talk to you all soon.